I got two really good prank call ideas, and then I didn't.
That's good.
Okay.
That's really good.
Are you on good. Top of your Two. Game? Mine are random as hell.
Mine are very random.
Okay.
Mine are from a very weird place.
Oh, we're rolling?
Oh. Hello!
Are you man and woman? You are now streaming Red American Podcast. Call S&D.
Hey,
welcome to the S&D podcast. I'm D.
I'm S, and we're joined by very funny Detroit native, Michigan's chosen person.
That's right.
Mr. Michael Hirsch. Oh,
give it up for him.
Very funny stand-up.
Give it up for him.
I'm the chosen person of Michigan.
That's what I heard. That's what I read.
I don't know a single other Jewish person.
According to the Michigan Sentinel. The Michigan Sentinel.
You guys are ill-informed.
What do you mean?
Yeah.
First of all,
there's no Michigan Sentinel.
Yes, there. Second, look that up. Hold on.
I know you're lying.
And second of all, we got plenty of Jews.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Do you guys have how many?
I just
remember.
At least a couple dozen.
Drove through the Midwest, and when I arrived back off the highway in Williamsburg, I felt like it was the first like Jewish person I'd seen in like a month, and I was happy to see them.
It happens a lot. It happens a lot in the Midwest.
I don't believe you guys.
It's really true.
I know a bunch of Jewish people in Chicago, Detroit.
Maybe we should start this episode.
Oh, there is, dude. There's the Michigan Sentinel Hospital Network.
Okay, that's not a
You're
newspaper.
From the Sentinel.
Come on, you guys bro. Are you acting crazy. This podcast, they're like, Jews aren't real.
No, I didn't say that.
Well, hang on.
I didn't say that. I just wanted you to be accountable for your claims about the Michigan Sentinel. I wanted you to be accountable for that, dude.
Is it hot in here?
It's really hot.
Is it hot?
I was thinking about wearing shorts, but then I went against. I've been doing no socks a lot of episodes, and then I got
almost showing cock in a lot of episodes.
I got a pair of sweat shorts that are a little bit.
When Connor's pervy ass zooms in on the TikTok.
Like it's in there,
the
dude.
Ken Burns effect.
Oh, yeah.
There's one where it's like pretty close to your...
Yeah, it's very in there.
But I think that's part of the appeal on TikTok is that you need to show that you have a hog.
Show body.
to the kids.
Show the kids. Yeah.
The D'Elia model.
Yeah. There's a new documentary now. Did you guys see that?
About Chris D'Elia?
Yeah. There's a new one.
About his philanthropy?
Yeah.
He made the right move.
Did you mix it up with philandering? Philandering and philanthropy?
Yeah, dude.
It's pretty raw. I don't know. I didn't watch it, but
Is it called like Surviving D'Elia?
Pretty much. It was made by another comedian.
Oh.
Another comedian created it.
Yeah, which one?
Oh, yeah,
I don't know his name.
That's because they're
But
not
he
good.
Think he's very good at he's good at editing.
And good at being jealous as fuck.
I mean, that's the biggest thing. But it was high production value. I was watching the promo for it. I was like,
it looked HD.
The floating HD. It could have been HBO. It could have been a real
thing. It might be one of those like Searching for Sugar Man things where they just did it on an iPhone.
Oh, it could
have
been.
And the new iPhones are so good.
I'm familiar
sneaky.
With that documentary. That's a great song. Sugar Man, what a song.
Yeah. Mm. Also, I actually, never mind. I just remembered that the guy who directed that movie was like made this whole big stink about how he filmed it on an iPhone.
Uh-huh.
And then it came out that he didn't. And then he just killed himself.
Oh, come on. He did?
Honestly, he killed himself because he was embarrassed.
Documentarians kind of, they lie a lot. They're kind of career cappers. Actually.
Coney. Come on, Coney.
Yeah. enormous life. That guy lost his fucking mind.
Yeah, Coney lost
Dude, Werner Herzog, the notorious liar and scammer.
What did he do?
Cold nihilist capping.
What was his deal?
What do you mean?
Well, Werner Herzog.
What, movies?
What did he do?
He's just a
He's
capper.
Like a famous
He's just
a
ca- he just
German.
Caps.
Oh.
He Werner Herzog is capper numero uno.
Right.
You want to address it? You want to call him out?
Speak on it.
Yo!
Yo,
Werner Herzog,
German fuck.
You stupid German fuck.
Yeah.
I know you're capping. I know you're lying. I don't know how to say that. And you're stupid. Gesamtkunstwerk Guten Tag, bitch.
Yep. You know what that means.
I mean something.
He's never been in a dark cave. He just talks about them.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
I need to see the spelunking record.
Yeah. Where's it at, dude?
How are you guys just straight up on this just calling people out?
Like, because that's what this is about.
I've seen pretty glued to Z-Way in multiple podcasts.
Yeah.
I think I'm upset. I might have a crush on her.
Yeah. I mean,
on
it could
Z-Way?
Be possible.
Yeah. I think her whole thing's very fascinating. The like setting people up for PR traps, but then they're like prepared for it. But then like while she interviews them, she like it's very clear she wants to be famous as well.
Yeah. She's
She's got skills. But wait, I love the concept of Z-weighing my friends, like editing them out of context.
Oh, my God, I would love to.
We should say, when we book people, we should say, we're probably going to
Z-weigh you.
Some gotcha journalism. If that's okay with you.
My name's Michael Hirsch. I'm from the Sentinel.
The Michigan Sentinel.
I'm from the Michigan Sentinel.
Which exists. You got to add that in there.
And also witches exist.
Uh-huh. Witches exist. Too.
Yeah, dude.
And they did all those bad things that witches I was accused of.
Yeah.
It was them.
Uh-huh.
Sir, I'm so stoned, guys. I stayed up so late last night.
No, I'm in a bad state.
What were you doing?
Yeah. I was getting late.
Up late on the late night.
Gossip corner.
Oh, here we go.
It was Pipe City. No, she's awesome.
Use promo code Hirsch to bet on the over and under of how long Michael lasted. Only on the number one sports book on DraftKings.
America's sports book is like, you can bet on all your friends' jizz times.
Yeah, they can open it up to anything. It's all legal now.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be cool. Dude, there's this.
That'd be cool. That'd
I want to know how fast my friends are busting.
Yeah.
I'd like to know.
But how do you gather the info? The lady tells you? The guy?
Yeah, because I mean...
Because I have ADD. I have time dilation. So I... You know what I mean?
To me, it's like an Inception situation.
To me, it was hours. You know what I mean? Yeah.
To my squirrel-ass brain.
Yeah, it was forever I was in there. I'm like, God, let me get
this was a lifetime.
Yeah, exactly.
Inception rules. Is the time's dilated in the... Yeah, in it's the coitus world.
You ever seen Interstellar?
Oh, yeah.
Sure. Yeah, sure. It's like that.
Yeah, when I... I'm just going at, you know, time dilation with, you know, I'm going closer to the speed of light. So time does slow down from the perspective of
the
me.
The bust is at the speed of light. So it slows down everything.
Dude, if you bust at the speed of light, it would slice someone in half.
Oh, probably, yeah.
Schrodinger's pussycat.
That's what that's what happens. That's
before
true.
I take my dick out, I've both not bust and bust at the same time.
My
until
God.
It's been perceived.
But by God.
By God. He's done it.
Oh, dude,
Dave Portnoy on the phone.
Dude, we need to get Neil deGrasse Tyson, dude. We need to get him on here. Run
if
that.
If anyone were to argue about the quantum mechanics of how fast they bust.
Dude, he would do it. He would.
I need
He'd be like,
see.
Actually.
He would.
Yeah.
I hate that guy.
Wait, which guy? ND,
Neil deGrasse Tyson. We got beef.
Yeah, NDT. Yeah.
We have beef, actually. Real beef.
Why? You and Neil?
He may there's a slight chance that he stole a joke from me.
Come on, bro.
Where I did a little character set as Adam Driver in 2019. And it went semi-viral. And then like 2 days later, he posted almost a verbatim joke from it, which was that, you know, it shouldn't have been called Marriage Story because they're not married very long in it. And, you know, I called him out, and then I actually ended up meeting his niece at a comedy show.
What?
And she was immediately very defensive. She's a very defensive person. And she told me to you know, keep my uncle's name out of your mouth.
How did you connect? She knew about the beef?
She knew about the, I don't know.
I want to say something to you, sir. Yeah. Oh my. Excuse me, sir. Oh my
God. I've been seeing what you've been saying online.
I see the tweets.
Dude, my nerd ass uncle. I will defend my nerd ass uncle's honor.
Exactly.
I respect defending an uncle honor.
Yeah. I wouldn't. That's fucked up.
But
honestly.
Uncles a lot of times betray you if you watch movies.
Yeah, uncles be
Scar.
Yeah, Scar.
I was thinking,
dude,
Scar
Hamlet.
Is top of
Hamlet. You seen The Norseman? You seen that movie?
Yeah,
we're kind of just describing the same core story.
It's the same movie. Lion King. It's all the same, but dude, the uncle, you can't trust him.
The
can't
uncle will fuck your mom.
Yeah, and I...
and wants to
it's
so
happened.
Bad.
And, yeah. is about to.
Yeah, it's gonna... God, it's so... It's fucked.
You don't really see that on like, porn, like, suggested. There's all kinds of
these uncle
cuckolds. The uncles who slips in, like,
dude,
after
I think Uncle Cuckold is a cool name for a musical artist.
Uncle Cuckold?
Cuckold?
It's got a really nice flow to it.
I like Uncle Cracker, but Uncle Cuckold. What are any of that guy's songs? Do we know
Uncle Cracker?
Oh, I remember that one.
Because I got high. No, that's not him. Who is the...
is
he?
I'm just going to pivot real quick because I can't remember.
I can't remember
I don't
either.
Know either.
We could look it up.
I don't care.
Maxim.
Google Uncle Cracker songs, please.
Uncle Cracker songs.
For our guest.
See, we don't... We don't have that relationship.
Chop, chop.
I shred of professionalism, please.
Yeah, come on, dude. We need to get more of a relationship where we're trying to figure out something. We have someone look it up. You know what I mean? Dude,
I think
we need
a Jamie type.
We need it.
I think we need someone who's willing to go there.
Because people are listening to this and they're going, what is it?
We joked about having Rowie as our intern before.
He'd be good.
But now he has a show at The Stand.
Yeah, he's doing.
There you go. Can't make him an intern anymore.
A stand-up comedy show?
He does, yeah.
A stand-up comedy show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I thought you were talking about like a podcast. And I was going to make
a podcast at The Stand?
He does that sometimes. Rowie's crazy.
He is a crazy
guy. He's a wild boy.
Rowie has like a very bizarre set of skills. A very particular and bizarre
set
of skills.
That's like the Taken. I have a very bizarre set of skills.
Yeah. The chosen incel.
Oh, yeah. But he always has a girlfriend.
Dude, he always has a girlfriend. Yeah. He has a girlfriend who, like...
I always see him with a lady.
Kidding, he's not really an incel, but...
No, he's
he knows a lot of incel
But he works
stuff.
At GameStop, and he talks about the incel.
He is basically...
Customer base.
He's so close.
He's an incel who got him some pussy.
Yeah. He did.
In, like, a chill vibes way. His girlfriend. His girlfriend's good vibes.
Mm-hmm. I never met. Well, I met. I don't know if it's the same girlfriend because I met her like a year ago.
Same girlfriend.
Same girlfriend.
That's the thing about him that you wouldn't even like register is like, oh, he's like a good boyfriend, like
family
a
man,
family. He's big. Yeah,
he is a family man.
He's always talking about nuclear family and traditional values.
Judeo-Christian values.
Yeah, he's super into Judeo-Christian values.
He's into it.
Family man, huh?
That's right.
Yeah.
What do you mean by family man?
Family guy.
Family guy.
Mm-hmm. I've been busting that shit down lately.
Really? You've been getting back into fam guy?
Oh, my family guy is just regular good.
Yeah.
You just rip a couple lines of ketamine and just watch them go. Yeah.
I was thinking about calling a ketamine dispensary lately because they're coming out now.
Wait, you can go there. Wait, where's their ketamine dispensary?
Is it legal?
I think I drove by one in California.
Oh, maybe there.
It's becoming...
Where's
the line, though?
Yeah,
with what can be a dispensary? I feel like even shroom dispensaries, I think that's fine.
I think they should have crack dispensaries.
Yeah.
Get one. Just
crack
and
meth.
Do you think there's like the movie Another Round? There's like a perfect amount of crack that you could do, and then it'd be totally fine.
Absolutely.
And actually enhance your life and make you good at sports.
There's going to... Yeah.
For sure.
You would be good at sports.
They're strong as fuck.
Oh, my God.
And pretty coordinated.
There's a lot of sports that you'd be good. Like cup stacking.
Yeah.
You know, think about that.
Were you on a cup stacking team? I was on a cup stacking team one time.
But I really?
In Maryland. Yeah.
For real?
That's so...
I remember watching and it's...
And then you hit the mat on your time.
Yeah, exactly.
You build it up.
Wait, you guys both know the rules?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot. I watched it one time. I watch it as a boy.
You guys are like...
What?
What do you mean, dude?
First of all, you guys are serious.
Yeah. We're real. Yeah. Cup stacking's real.
David's like, I watched it as a boy.
I did. I never had the courage.
No matter what this episode, he talks like he was like born in like 1955.
You talked about like you owned the video games, dude.
Dude, I watched it as a boy and I was in wonder.
And then you were on a fucking team?
I was on the squad. First team.
Yep.
All state. Captain. Uh-huh. Captain.
I was singles. I didn't have no teammates. You can't pair me with nobody. They're like, Sean is too high. I'm like, shut the fuck up.
He's a lone wolf.
Yeah, do you practice with just lighter, with heavier cups?
That's how you build
like
it up.
Rock Lee taking the weights off. You gotta train your arms.
No, he trained in elevation. He went to the mountains and did it.
Rock Lee?
Yep.
Wait,
Rock Lee.
Is that not from Naruto?
Yeah, I referenced Naruto.
Oh, I don't know about that. I imagined Bruce
having weights
Lee
on
the
your
rock
arms
together.
Oh, what?
I thought that was Bruce Lee and the Rock. Some type of a remix.
No.
Bruce Lee times the Rock.
Yeah, I was like, damn, that's a perfect
the
man.
Rock Lee.
I'm like, oh shit, I didn't even know about that.
Dude, can you smell what the Rock Lee is cooking?
Yeah, you're gonna be fucked up, bro.
This is for my weebs. This is for my nerds out there.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out
to them.
For our 11.
Dude, yeah, this is for, honestly, I feel like from what I've read about this podcast on the App Store. This on the Google Play Store, is that most of your fan base is weebs.
Yep.
Yeah.
So if you guys could talk about anime more, that would be great.
We need to.
Max have just went a little viral on TikTok for comparing his parents' divorce to Mecha Gundam fighting.
What?
And all the comments were like, preach.
Freeze, brother! Oh my god, that's sick.
The giant, the giant robot was my parents' divorce hearings.
Oh,
the giant.
Oh. The beam sword was sort of me going back and forth every other weekend.
Dude, that's funny.
Dude, Max, if you want to jump in. You want to chime in?
And what's up with that Uncle Cracker stuff?
Yeah, do we
did
have
we
his,
get any...
his hit single? Do we have it?
Do we get
jump?
Okay. He didn't want to waste the bandwidth.
He's thinking about his parents' divorce.
took him right out of it.
Took him right out of it.
Drift away.
So smooth. What's up? I'm Uncle Gringo. This is Drift Away.
Yo, Uncle Gringo.
I'm T.O. White. My cousin, he's married to a very nice Peruvian
Busty
woman. And he's about to have. No.
No.
And he's about to have a Peruvian child. And just now when I saw him the other day,
what?
I told him that I was going to tell his child to call him a gringo when he's like mad at him. And he's like, my stupid gringo ass dad won't let me go out tonight. I instructed him to do so.
Should we hit some calls?
Yeah.
Should we ranch some calls?
Is there water? Can I drink that?
You want to drink?
You want to drink from David's secret cup?
This is coffee. Both have been heavily drank by me, but you can ranch it. You want some real water?
Is this not real water?
It's real. It's from it's from the tap, brother. You drink tap?
I drink tap.
It's just New York.
Some people are against it.
It's the best tap water. Some
people are soft.
The best tap water this side of the Mississippi.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Yeah. According to the Michigan Sentinel.
According to the Michigan Sentinel.
That's number two.
Michigan Sentinel. You ain't never had no water like this.
You ain't never tasted it.
From the Michigan Sentinel.
Pop it, baby.
And drift away.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, hit that. Get that. That's a good call to get some water in you.
I wanted to hydrate my mouth because I know I'm about to be going off.
Yeah. You want to be dry. They're going to catch you. If you're dry.
Yeah, they'll be
dry.
Like, wait a minute, this is a prank.
Wait a goddamn minute.
This guy's too dry to be sincere. Yeah.
This guy just swallowed again.
You just licked your lips.
I can hear it.
Sir, your mouth sounds dry.
Something's afoot.
Something's going on.
I would love if someone said on a prank call, something's afoot.
Something is afoot here.
I hate when something's afoot.
Dude, isn't that the worst?
Shit, be staying afoot.
Mm-hmm.
It's always afoot. Something goes always.
Dude, now it's go time.
Now it's for real. Now it's Howard Stern.
Now it's real shit. So the only thing is, we're going to call on this phone and don't do speaker and just do *67. All right?
Don't do speaker?
Don't click speaker because I made that mistake and I paid dearly.
Oh, yeah. Who figured that was it? Was it Ryan? That was just like, don't fucking speak, you fucking moron.
Yeah, it's tech. Ryan's good at tech. A lot of people don't know that.
Wait, a lot of people don't know that. Ryan O'Toole.
No, I see that for him.
You see it? Imagine him in IT.
Yeah. Him, he's like,
did you restart the thing? Did you even restart it?
You even restarted, dude?
He's I don't know, dude. Get a new one.
He like goes to work. He's like sagging his jeans so much and has a tank top. His hat is all the way to the side.
Oh, my God.
He's like Lord of the Nerds. I think he's like so cool.
I don't know my password either.
You gotta put a special fucking symbol in there, dude.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude, kid.
Dun, dun, dun. Shamrock emoji is my password. So what?
Shamrock emoji. Typed out.
That's my password. Who cares? All right, I'm going to give IHOP a call.
Where at?
Just right nearby.
Oh, okay. Maybe.
Maybe. Maybe the because there's one right by us.
And then when...
Oh, are you going to call an IHOP too?
No.
Oh, okay.
When we're laughing.
Yeah.
You just got to push it away. Got to push the mic away. That's all.
Oh, because they can hear us through these.
We're all live.
It all connects to the phone.
Oh, we're hot.
Yeah, we're all live.
This is like a conference call type of sitch.
This is probably
just chiming in, having a conference call with IHOP is perfect. Just want to chime in.
And who just dialed in? Who is that?
Oh, my God. I would love to, instead of like a classic prank call, dial into like a Zoom conference at a major corporation.
Oh, that would be so, and just, oh my
we should ask people to give us like office codes. I knew this guy on Instagram. He was really funny. When like all that like remote school was happening, he'd be like, "Yo, give me your class ID and I'll like crash your class." Oh. And he was so good at it.
That's so dude, that'd be
he was
so
like, fun. Question, please. And then he was like really like 35.
Yeah. Was it colleges or was it like high school?
It was colleges.
That'd be awesome if it was high school. And it's like, I'm a new student.
I'm new.
I'm
here.
35. That'd be cool. If you,
I'm 35, scream
that. I'm 35. I'm 35. Just got out of a coma.
Fuck. At least I think. Okay, here we go. Here's IHOP.
This is IHOP.
Thank you for calling IHOP. I'm
okay. Hello. Is this IHOP?
Yes.
All right. I got a question about a gift card. Now, I had purchased a gift card for $25 for an uncle of mine, and I'm going to need y'all to hike that up to
$10,000?
$10,000, that's correct. I got a big uncle. He just got out of jail. He's hungry.
Okay, give me one second.
He's real hungry. He's got that hunger in him. Hello? Are you out there, IHOP? Hello?
How much longer should I wait?
Call another
IHOP. Why don't I just all scream at the same time and hope he hears it?
I think yeah.
Just real quick, right?
Okay, here we go.
One more time.
Okay, here we go.
Yep.
And one, two, three.
IHOP!
Anyway, all right, I'm gonna call a different one.
Oh, okay,
that's the good thing about IHOP is that there's literally so many. We can just
there's
keep,
so
we
many.
Could just all do IHOPs.
Yeah, I was thinking, should we call one in a more friendly place? Because New York restaurants sometimes they don't really fuck around.
Let me try one
on Woodward in Michigan. Woodward in 11 Mile.
In 11 Mile.
In 8 Mile.
Not 8 Mile.
In 8 Mile Road. IHOP 8 Mile.
As a native,
I don't sound like that.
My eggs are sweaty, knees are weak.
The IHOP
mom's pecan cakes.
And if he blows it, we just scream again.
Don't fuck it up.
I'll try to be nicer this time.
Good afternoon, David calling. I'm 14 shooting this one of you.
Hey, how you doing? I had a quick question about a gift card.
Yeah, what's the question?
Yeah, so I had purchased a $25 gift card, and I'm going to need y'all to hike that up to
$10,000. I need you to hike that up.
Come on, bro. All right, let me call a nicer place.
But yeah, you want to call your hometown
you go
IHOP?
First. You go first.
My hometown IHOP?
Yeah, call him up. Tell him your Uncle Rutherford just got a job.
All right. Oh, actually, I know of IHOP. I'd like to call too.
Oh yeah, it's all
just do it.
Headphones, I guess. I've never even had that question on my phone.
Let's see, fucking motherfucking. Oh, IHOP Woodward. My mom said that this is the IHOP where all the prostitutes would hang out.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm about to call a sketchy one too in Providence where like a bunch of people get like stabbed and stuff.
Oh.
I'm gonna demand pancake compensation. My cousin was fucking stabbed and he's like dying in my arms. At least I could do is get like a stack or something.
Can I get something? A couple strips of bacon for this guy?
Okay, hold on. I got an idea. Okay.
Thank you for calling your local IHOP. You can also check us out online at IHOP.com or the IHOP mobile app, where you can take advantage of our easy online ordering system.
There's no way.
To notify arrival, For curbside pickup, press 1. To place an order, press 2. To speak to a member of our staff, press 3.
3.
Yep.
Facts.
Thanks for calling IHOP. This is Candy. How can I help you?
Hey, Candy. This is Michael.
Hey, Mike.
Hey. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Honestly, I'm a bit concerned, but generally I'm pretty good. My son, he's about 11 years old. I left him at the IHOP.
What?
Yeah.
What do you mean you left him at what IHOP?
I left him at the IHOP on Woodward. I left
him. Oh, Royal Oak, I don't see him. I don't see an 11-year-old.
Would you mind checking the bathroom? He's there with his...
The bathroom?
Yeah, I brought him there with his girlfriend who's 17
okay,
years old.
Okay, hold on 1 second. Let me see. Hold on.
Yeah. And okay.
Yeah, I don't see an 11-year-old.
You don't. He loves whipped cream. If would it be possible? You could just put out a couple of short stacks, just cover them in whipped cream. He'll probably
Friday 13. Bye.
Spooky, oh, spooky.
Damn.
No, we're still on the line. No, she
clicked it.
She clicked it. She said Friday 13th. Bye. Wow. How about bye to you?
Call it back, say that.
Excuse me. That was almost, I almost got something.
That
good.
Was pretty good.
That was
a great first impression. Hey, Mike.
Hey, Mike.
At first, I was so like, happy. I was going to fully abandon ship and be like, should I just try to fuck this lady?
Should I see what I can do?
Is this the love of my life?
Oh my God, she's about to change my life. Do you want the.
Yeah, yeah.
I have another idea. And it's because my son is lost.
Just put a short stack. I forgot it was Friday the 13th. So that's interesting that she knew that things would be afoot. Is that even a thing to break out? Friday the 13th. It's not like Halloween. It's
it's not like a devil's night.
It is now devil's night. Yeah, it's now a spooky
episode. With these three guys on the pod, it's devil's night.
It's devil's
baby.
Night. It's fella's night at Devil's Lounge.
Dude, this is one of those podcasts where women aren't allowed to listen, right?
We surmise that maybe there's a singular female listener.
We don't say it explicitly
from the data.
But we had one lady on the most views we've ever had on the episode.
Who, Lee?
Danielle DeLudi.
Oh,
most views.
Shout out.
Yeah. Shout out DD.
That's right.
Double D.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
Well, I forgot to star 67 that last place.
Oh, well, that's
it
your
usually
phone.
Doesn't
it's my,
matter.
It's my phone it's number. Phone, it's my
so,
phone number.
And she's your soulmate, so you probably shouldn't.
You want to get in contact with
you
her.
You probably
again.
Want to drop that number.
I want her to have my information.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Are you calling that IHOP in Providence?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you for calling IHOP in Providence. If you'd like to place a delivery order, please visit ihop.com. If you'd like to place a pickup order or speak with an in-store associate, press 1. Hours and
thank you for calling IHOP in Providence. So we think speaking, how can I help you?
Hey, how you doing? I got kind of a peculiar question for you. My cousin, a few years back, he was, there's no other way to say it. He was kind of stabbed in the parking lot of your IHOP. And, I think he's like, almost about to die or something. He's bleeding out. One of your IHOP employees, he was nice enough to help me, but he kind of did. He said, I can't believe this happened here. I'm so sorry. Maybe I could compensate you with some food later on. And I know I'm a little late on that, but I was hoping maybe to get some compensation for, just like a free stack or something.
The only thing is, you should have taken it at that moment. Right now, the general manager of this restaurant already left.
No, what's his name? I think I met the guy.
David Morales is his name.
Dave Morales.
That's the general manager.
Okay, yeah. Dave. Yeah, right. He just left.
Yeah, you would have to speak with him. He's not here right now.
Okay.
He left for the day.
Yeah.
You can probably try back tomorrow. He'll be here tomorrow between 9 and 3.
Okay, but I'm just.
He's not here right now.
Yeah, no, I'm just letting you know, this is it Providence. It's, it's kind of a.
Correct, but he has to do it.
It's just an old-fashioned thing. A man gave me his word, and in Providence, that goes a long way.
Exactly, but
especially with my family, if you understand what I'm saying.
Correct. Yeah, you just got to take it. When he's here, just come and talk to him when he's here.
Yeah, no, I get that, but he made an oath on my cousin's life. I mean, he was halfway gone. I mean, he was seeing my granny and everything like that, and he just promised me a few stacks. I don't see what the huge problem is.
Yeah, but like I said, I can't authorize that because I know nothing about it, and I can't just give it out. You know what I mean? You have to talk to him specifically.
All right, sorry.
Or you should have taken moment. Yeah.
No, I'm sorry. I got a little heated before. Sorry. It's just,
all right. But anyway, like I said, just call back tomorrow or talk to him tomorrow.
One second before. But yeah, like I know, always like a lot of shit goes down in the parking lot. After the clubs get out. And so anything crazy happening lately? Are you guys all right? They let you carry guns or something?
Correct. I mean, like I said, the thing is, I work morning and second shift. I don't work, third shift. So
smart.
I don't know.
You're fucking smart, dude. I've seen some, Mad Max shit, no rules.
I know.
Laissez-faire shit in
we
that fucking parking lot. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, correct.
All right, so you're smart. You're smart about that. You got a family, man. That's smart. If you got a family, you shouldn't be working at night at that fucking place. I mean, if they tell you to, tell them no. All right, tell them. Dom said you can't. You can't do it.
Like I said, just call back tomorrow.
Yeah. Dave Morales. He's the big boss, man.
He is the big boss.
What's your favorite pancake before you go? I want to know what to order.
I like the New York cheesecake, but I'm the only server on here at the moment, so I'm going to have to let you go.
Yeah, okay, you get back to it. You got a little sweet tooth. Who am I talking to, by the way? I'm Dom. Who am I talking to?
I'm Felipe.
Oh, Filippo. And nice to meet you, man. And,
okay, like I said, just call him tomorrow.
Okay, you tell Dave that Dominic called. He'll know my name.
All right,
Dominic
up
on Federal Hill, okay? Yeah, just let him know. All right.
All right,
take care. All right, thank you. I just listened to the Crime Town about Providence. Dude, it's I grew up there, but I did not know how mobbed up it was so recently. So I was trying to say, just you make a promise to my family. Like if you hear that in Providence, you're for sure, free pancakes, no problem. That was pretty fun though.
The mob's gotten worse there now?
No. But it's a small
gentrification.
These the fucking been... yuppies and the tech company are coming in on our territory. they just
Patagons.
It's just eventually the feds got their asses with taxes and stuff and got them all to snitch on each other and they imploded. Classic.
It's a classic move.
Classic move.
It's a classic.
I'm past the mic. What else we got? IHOP was a fun idea for all three
of us. IHOP is a great.
IHOP, UHOP, WeHOP, and it's the devil's night.
It's a great situation.
I get it's Friday the 13th. What a great
Friday the 13th. Yeah, she drew some connections.
It's because in Michigan, people are very superstitious.
Yeah. Are they really? Are they stitched up?
Sure, yeah.
Stished.
Stisherino.
Tell him Dom called. He'll know
Stishy.
Me. It's Dom on Federal Hill.
So these dumb fucks.
Oh, gosh.
Oh.
I burped.
Uh-oh.
Bro, you be burping.
I'll be burping.
Little Burp. That'd be a funny little name. Oh.
Wait, who is this?
This is a spa.
Williams, is somebody help you?
Hi. I'd like to schedule a couples massage.
We don't do massages.
Oh, well, could you?
This is facial spa.
Please, because I kind of have this booked. I have this booked in my head already, and it's really hard to get it out of there. Is there any way that you could bring someone in just for a quick rub down?
We don't do massages here. This is our facial spa.
Oh, that, you know what? Actually, that's perfect. Because I do have boils in that area. Could you please do a couple's facial?
But when? Our appointment is Monday.
As soon as possible. Monday would be perfect. At dawn?
Come on!
Friday the 13th.
Wait, why did she even hang up? She just lost business.
Yeah,
because I said at dawn. I think. Dawn. All right, let me call one more spot.
Dawn. Yeah, you should just said at dawn. What the fuck?
I think a couple's facial at dawn.
At dawn. It's like meet a cowboy at dawn for my
cowboy.
We
showdown.
Ride at dawn. Dude, all right, look, one more spa, dude. I gotta.
We cleanse at dawn.
One shot, two, three, two, shot, four.
Were you a big D12 guy growing up, Michael?
No.
Thank you for calling Chateau Glow, located at 230 Bushwick Avenue in Brooklyn. To book an appointment, please visit our website, chateauglowskin.com. If you have any further questions, please send us a text or leave us a message, and we will get back to you as soon as we can. Thanks.
Hello, I'm looking to book a couple's massage. Please call me back. Thank you so much. Max, take that out of there.
Take that number.
Yeah, that is. But I want them to call me back. But here, okay, what? I got one more spa number, and if this doesn't work, Michael,
we get to
hit this
kill
ranch.
You.
Yeah, you could kill me too.
Hit this motherfucker.
I've pretty much
shit.
Done everything in life that I want to do.
Yeah, you're done.
I've pretty much done it all.
You basically accomplished all of
Mount Rushmore.
Goals.
Many lifetimes of achievements.
Exactly, dude. A lot of Xbox achievements.
And, yeah, you pretty much have the life any man would want.
Boss.
Biggest.
That's a good character.
No money fed.
I do want to call Wingstop as Rick Ross.
I was checking in on things. Oh, it's me, the boss.
In Miami, that might work.
I think
it's me, the ball.
We should try it.
They go, what size you want?
Biggest.
Biggest.
It's me, Shaquille O'Neal. I'm calling Papa John's. I want a Buick.
Give me a Buick stat.
I need a Buick now.
I need a Buick before the day is over. Hello?
Please leave your message for 347.
Oh, I should have done one. I shouldn't have done one here because they're probably all closed. Big mistake.
You gotta go West Coast with all these things, or at least mountain time.
I got one in. I was gonna call. Ooh, I think they're calling me back.
Pass the mic.
Pop it in.
Hello.
Hi, this is Chateau Glow returning a phone call.
Hi, my name is Bill Nguyen. I was looking to schedule a couple's massage with you guys.
I'm sorry, we don't provide massages. We only do facial services.
Okay, a couple's facial would actually be even better because of my boil situation.
Is this a prank call or something?
What? No,
is this a prank call?
I'm looking to do a couple's facial for Valentine's Day.
Okay. Well, if you said you had a boil, unfortunately, you wouldn't be able to treat somebody with a boil. We would recommend seeing a dermatologist first.
What if it goes away by then? And that's also
if it goes
quite ableist.
I'm sorry.
It's quite ableist.
I'm sorry. We wouldn't be able to treat somebody with a boil until it's not there any longer.
But how am I supposed to get a facial?
You can get a facial from a dermatologist. Unfortunately, we wouldn't be able to treat you with a boil, with an active boil.
Okay, it's not very active. I don't really work out.
Okay, this is obviously a prank call, and this is a business, so we don't appreciate prank calls. Is that a business?
My life is not a prank. I'm looking for a couples massage.
Again, we don't provide massages. Have a great night. Don't call this number again.
You too. God bless you.
Should I call that?
We should call back as like be like his like boyfriend or something.
Yo, this is
he's very shy. He has phone anxiety. His face is riddled with boils. This is an outrage.
How dare you?
Should I call that?
Yeah,
call him.
Totally.
You gotta do *67.
But just do your normal voice.
But they didn't answer when I called. I had to leave a number.
What's the number? Should I do it?
Oh,
and then I got a good one.
I'll give it to you right now. It's that top number.
The line I was trying to give you before she got off was, us boil bearers have faced much prejudice.
My sweet boyfriend, Billy.
Thanks for calling Chateau Glow. How can I help you?
Hey, this is Michael. My boyfriend Bill Wynn just called, and he said that you were treating him with great disrespect. So, people who have boils have actually had to face a great deal of trauma throughout American history, and so your ableist comments are certainly going to be included on our Yelp review for your business.
Great. Sounds good. Again, we don't appreciate prank calls.
I don't think you understand what a prank call is. This clearly isn't that. You are disrespecting my sweet Billy, and I don't appreciate your tone. Do you understand?
You're on a recorded line.
You know what? Good, because then your manager can hear you.
Okay, that's great. Do you have anything else to say?
I give your business 1 out of 5 boils. You're very mean. You're very mean.
Okay, well, have a great day, Michael and Bill.
Bill Wynn. It's Bill Wynn.
Okay, have a great night.
It's William to you.
Wow.
I mean, it was good for that, but then I thought it was too funny. That was pretty funny.
You should do one more, and then I want to call her back. Give it a beat.
My grandson has been calling your business.
Have you been ableist to my 2 gay grandsons?
They're riddled with boils.
Actually, wait, they can't be both the grandsons.
They are. This is my gay.
Don't think about it too much.
Okay, let's see.
I was hoping to get a facial.
Yeah, I really wanted one. God, do I just have to do a normal voice now?
No, don't get in your head, man. This is the first fucking time this ever happened. Apparently, people know Friday the 13th. They get phone-based businesses 13th, apparently know.
Weird. Phone, yeah.
Yeah, I guess they know.
I guess they're in. Fuck, they're tapped in.
Fuck me, I guess.
Maybe there's a lot of prank call podcasts.
That cannot be true. It's not true.
I haven't done a lot of research.
No, I have not either.
But maybe.
And I think a lot of people actually accidentally stumble on our page trying to type in D&D.
Right.
Not something I thought of.
Or S&D Search and Destroy from Call of Duty. That's a big one.
Or the song by SZA.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Also that. Yep, we're getting a lot of SZA fans. Shout out to her.
So this is what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to call this magic shop. Like this, like it's like a like a magic bookstore.
Yes.
That's in Bushwick, and I'm going to try to buy a grimoire summon. They're going to ask me why. And I'm going to be like, I want to summon some sort of Rumpelstiltskin like demon.
Go for it.
Catland Books. Hey, this is Toby. I just wanted to make sure I was connected to Catland Books.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, amazing. I was curious. I wanted to reach out to you guys to see if you guys had any grimoires.
Are you looking for like a blank grimoire?
No, I'm looking for a grimoire that is currently filled with spells and incantations, if you guys have one available.
Let me see what we have.
Thank you.
In terms of like spell books, right now the only thing that we really have in stock is going to be like a monthly magical record keeper, which does have some spells in it.
What are the use cases for the spells in there?
Sorry, say that again.
What are the use cases for some of those spells? Are they pretty baseline, or what are we thinking?
Yeah, they've got, I'm looking through it, spells for blessings, unblocking energy, letting go, detachment, visions.
And these spells, and this is a, what, it's monthly magazine, these are good spells?
Yeah, I mean, it's a good, like, working model if you're trying to, like, actively be, like, performing ritual and kind of documenting the outcomes.
Interesting. Yeah, so I'm trying to focus more on summoning and incantation. If you have anything for that, and you know, have any of those rituals been working for you?
I don't really follow anything that's in a book. I kind of do my own thing. But we do have
kind of freestyle, like, avant-garde sort of.
Yeah, we do have things like the Goetia and. We have like a big book on ceremonial magic, if that's something that you're a little bit more interested in, like the Western mystery tradition.
I'm kind of getting into this more. I've kind of tipped the wagon, if you will. So I'm kind of curious to sort of hear your methodologies or, you know, kind of, do you have like a class or something where I can kind of learn how to do sort of what you're describing as sort of like free wielding kind of spells?
Let's see. So for this month, yeah, we actually, let's see, on the 14th, I think that is tomorrow. Yeah, we start a 3-week course called Secular Witchcraft. That would be a good introduction on like being a like solo practitioner and kind of figuring out what your path and what your rituals look like to you. You can check out that event through our website. It's catlandbooks.com, and then under the events tab, it'll just take you over to Eventbrite, and then you can read the description for the class.
That sounds amazing.
All of the classes are held through Zoom, and if you can't attend live, you get a recording to watch up for 30 days.
Oh, perfect. And I'm hoping we're going to be able to sort of learn some spells that I can kind of cast on groups of people.
On groups of people?
Yeah. Ideally, and you know, any sort of, and this is secular witchcraft, I'm kind of looking to get into some more pagan or Christian witchcraft that'll allow me to cast spells on groups of people.
Yeah, I mean, if you, I'm sure it wouldn't be a stretch to kind of take the ideology like behind casting and ritual magic, and as opposed to applying it to a single individual, applying it to a group of people.
Okay, perfect. Okay, I'm writing this down. Yeah, I'm just trying to look at something where I kind of, you know, the cast a wide net. I'm trying to cast spells on large swaths.
I would definitely say check out that class, and then all of the books that we carry are all on our website as well.
Oh, amazing. And is there anything sort of, you know, you kind of maybe touch on this a little bit, but something I'm really kind of hoping to do more of is you know, summon change. Maybe if I could change the outcomes of elections, or ideally I'd love to summon some sort of Rumpelstiltskin like demon that can kind of weave baby's flesh into golden threads, if that's possible.
I mean, if you're talking about like summoning spirits, definitely check out on our website. I believe we have available, there's a zine. It's called Demonology 101.
Zines are perfect. That's honestly the perfect length for me. And this is you guys have like an accreditation as far as sorcerers go. Is there like a sorcerer accreditation process?
Not really, no. Hmm. No, we don't have any type of accreditation here, no.
Yeah, you know how it is, large tech layoffs, so I'm kind of trying to make a career pivot, and this is something I've been fascinated in for quite a while. I've been promising a few close friends and family, great wealth and power beyond their beliefs, so
I would definitely check out our the classes that we have to offer, and again, all of our books and texts are going to be
in. Hopefully,
carry in store is going to be on the website.
And
well,
there's something where I could, you know, maybe some spells where I'd be able to cast on my old boss to render him blind, or.
There's nothing that comes to mind. I would maybe, yeah, like
or
I said,
something maybe
website,
that I could rig a jury.
I mean, that sounds like, I don't know about that, but there's definitely like different types of magical paths and traditions.
I'm going to keep it square with you. The DA is out for me and I need magic.
Yeah. Like I said, there's nothing that I can personally do for you, but yeah, I would say definitely check out like the books that we have to offer.
My back's against the wall. Magic is true. I was working at Twitter. I was at Twitter. Elon took over. You know, I can't stand working for that slime bag. So I'm trying to make the pivot into magic, and I feel like my back is sort of against the wall, and my my public defender is saying that I'm fucked.
Listen, pal. You're getting 20 years no matter what.
Yeah, he hung up.
Magic people are so funny.
Dude, they were so, do we think we got a clip out of that one, fellas?
Yeah, oh, bro, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the DA is out for me.
Render my boss blind, bro.
One time I went into that bookstore. I like was like it was like
the number the spot number. Yeah.
I was like
for the spa. It's top one.
Peak COVID. Like I was living in Bushwick, and like I was like I'm gonna fucking summon some demons. I'm gonna go to that bookstore, and then I pull up, and then like the dude working there, I said, "Can I get a grimoire?" And he's like, "What are you gonna use it for?" And I was like, "Summoning."
I can't just sell these. I gotta run a background check.
He's like a cop for it.
Yeah, oh, like this is like a gun. And I was like,
I need to protect this realm.
Is there a warrant out for your arrest?
Well, then I was like, I want to summon demons and shit, and he was like, no. You're gonna need to just display some responsibility.
And wait, what was your name? Bill Wynn?
Bill Wynn.
Bill Wynn.
W-I-N.
Okay. Yeah.
And Mike Jarmusch.
Maybe it's the block number thing. I'm just gonna do it. Do it
straight. Just fucking,
out.
Just fucking
go raw
dog that.
Yeah, I don't give a shit, son. Dude.
Free ball it. What are they gonna do? Block your number? Who
exactly.
cares? Exactly. You should accuse them of being like, okay, well, here's the let's get the facts straight. I went into your business and you gave me a disease.
I got boils from your spa.
You
okay,
know okay, what okay, you okay, did. Okay, okay.
Thank you for calling Chateau Glow, located at 230 Bushwick Avenue in Brooklyn. To book an appointment, please visit our website, chateauglowskin.com. If you have any further questions, please send us a text or leave us a message, and we will get back to you as soon as we can. Thanks.
Hi there. I was just wondering, I'm kind of new to the whole skincare thing, and I was just wondering if I could, what the rates were for just like getting a facial. I got some kind of dry skin that's sort of been embarrassing me for a while, and I just, like to jump on the phone and just get, a second opinion or something. Call me back soon, hopefully. Thanks.
That was good, dude. That was good as hell.
I need help.
I'm embarrassed. Yeah.
I'm going to call a Chinese restaurant and then pretend to be a guy at a barber shop who's like, yo, can we do that?
Yeah, sure.
Sure. Hit it up, bro. Who's like, yo? Yeah, I got one after this, too. We got...
Hey yo Ray, shut the fuck up back there. Hey yo, yeah, hey, is it Yummy 88? Is this
That's a great name too. Yummy 88.
Hey yo Ray.
Yeah, that's pretty vibes. I kind of want some shitty Chinese food.
Chinese is delish.
Rip it, rock it, put it in my pocket.
Son.
Hoes on my meat, and she says she want plop it. Ha, ha, ha.
Plop it.
She says she want to plop it. Stop it.
Harsh, this is Sierra. How can I help you?
Hi, Sierra. I had a question about some of your products that you guys carry.
Okay, give me just a second, and I'll transfer you to customer service, and I can answer all of them for you.
I just had a really quick question about the eggnog.
We are out of eggnog.
Okay, now do you guys carry egg white eggnog? Because I'm looking to watch my weights the new year. I have some goals.
I actually do not know. I will transfer you to customer service.
Okay, please transfer me to the egg white expert.
Check out and watch your savings
grow. Download the Harps Rewards app today. It's a great day at Harps. This is Erica. How can I help you?
Hi, Erica. It's a great day here as well. I had a quick question about your guys' eggnog selection.
Okay.
Now, I understand that you guys are running a little bit low. Obviously, it's out of season right now. But I'm wondering if you guys have an egg white eggnog, because I'm looking to get jacked for the summer.
I don't believe that we have any eggnog at this point. Since the holiday is over, we haven't received any more in.
Okay. Is it possible for me to reserve the first carton that you receive? What do you call it? What is that called? The wooden thing? A pallet. A pallet of that eggnog.
A pallet? So that would have to be a special request. So you would need to call back tomorrow morning, and you can speak with one of the grocery manager or the store manager to make a request like that.
And if I can just kind of give you, I would love to do that. I'm going to call them tomorrow. If I can just give you a quick backstory. Basically, growing up, I always ate eggnog. I loved it. I always had an eggnog mustache. Slugged the stuff. Did you know you have to heat up eggnog? Because it's raw eggs. You have to boil it.
Is this a serious phone call, or am I wasting my time?
It's beach season coming up. And I'm looking for egg white eggnog.
Egg white eggnog.
Bro, they got your number today. God damn, bro.
Dude, I couldn't. Oh,
man. As a boy, I just slugged this stuff. Here, let me try the fucking thing one last time. And then if not, we'll... Don't worry, Maxim. We'll get out of here.
We'll get out of here quick.
For the fucking...
Is that the
Tony
spa? Is it the spa? Yeah.
Can I help you?
Hi, I was just wondering what your rates were for a facial. I'm sorry, I'm kind of new to this stuff.
Yeah, no problem. Give me one second.
Yeah, sure.
Hello? Hello?
Yeah, these people are pieces of shit. They're pieces of shit.
All right, guys. That's been the S&D podcast. just get really quiet if she
You could mute it and we could do the outro.
Oh, that's true. All right, guys, that's been the S&D podcast.
God bless you.
Yeah, our great guest, Michael Hirsch. Michael, anything you'd like to plug?
Yes. I just want to plug plug both of you guys for putting on a good podcast.
You can plug me anytime, brother.
You can plug me again.
And by the time this episode comes out, I don't know if I'll have anything to promote anymore.
Oh. Yeah, we almost always do that. But
I have a show tomorrow. But,
there you go.
But you guys aren't gonna be there.
What show is it?
It's a drunk family dinner at Union Hall, 10 p.m.
There you go.
Yeah.
If nothing else, the plug is good for, you know, a little clout. This year's all about clout maxing.
Yeah.
I have a show at Union Hall.
And clout management. That's a big thing.
Clout management.
That's very
it's all in the clout.
Thanks for holding. So you wanted to know about the cost for facials, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So we have two options, 30 minute and 60 minutes.
Gotcha.
Is there one that you were more interested in?
Well, I'll be honest. I'm kind of just one of those guys that's had like a beard for a long time, and I've kind of like ignored some pretty rough dry skin underneath it. So, you know, new year, mm-hmm. new me, just trying to, you know, deal with that. So do you think like a 60 yeah. minute would be more like beneficial in terms of like costs, you know, effectiveness, I guess?
Yeah. So if it's texture due to like congestion, then a 60 minute would definitely be the way to go because
okay.
you can do extractions there.
Gotcha.
But if it's more of just like dry skin, then you could probably get away with doing one of the 30 minute facials so that we can just focus on hydration with.
Oh, you think I could get away with it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay,
if you,
cool.
You know, wanted something quicker.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I wasn't sure if it's like you need like the full hour to like get, you know, all the way in there, or whatever. Yeah, again, I'm kind of new to skincare. You know, so.
Yeah, no worries. It's really for the extractions, and then of course you do get the enhancement and finisher with that as well.
Okay, and
with the 60 minutes.
Yeah, I guess I just one other thing I want to mention. I do have these sort of. Yeah, I don't know. Again, like I've kind of been mistreating my skin for a long time. I kind of have these, I guess you'd call them boils or whatever. That like that wouldn't be a problem, would it?
That's something we could look at when you're here.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Do you need my my name or anything for an appointment?
Yeah, if you want to book an appointment, we would take down your name, phone number, and email, and then we would need a credit card to hold the appointment as well.
Okay, great. My name is John Wynn.
Sorry, give me 1 second. What day would you look to come?
Monday would be good. And you guys don't do I couldn't like bring, you know, like any of my like friends for the same appointment, could I? There's no like couples facials or anything like that?
No.
Oh, okay, good.
One at a time.
One-on-one treatment. Okay, cool.
This Monday we're all booked up.
Okay.
Is there another day that would work for you?
Wednesday maybe.
Sorry, looks like Wednesday we're also booked.
Okay. When's the next availability? You guys are popping off, huh?
Yeah, we usually do book a few days in advance. So we do have an opening on Tuesday morning.
Okay, great. And once again, you're sure that the boils wouldn't be a problem?
I'm not sure. Okay. That's something that we would have to just kind of
totally fair. I know it's like kind of a weird thing.
No worries.
Yeah. And
right, give me 1 second.
Yep, sure.
Hello? Hello?
Anyway, you can check me out at Local Dingus on Instagram and Twitter. I don't really have anything going right now. I've been on the road for a while, and I'm
road dog.
Road dog. But hit the TikTok, the S&D Pod at S&D Pod. We're kind of popping off
that
over
button's
there.
Gonna be right here.
Yeah. And
click this motherfucking button.
Click that link below. Click
that
click
button.
This link below.
Click the
click
link.
Click
the
right
link here,
click
buddy.
That link.
David, anything you want to plug?
Follow me on Instagram at Pastor Dave Bless. Okay, there's going to be a lot of good content there, a lot of good clips. Also, subscribe to the YouTube if you haven't. Please do that. Okay, we're trying to get this thing popping.
We almost got 100 subscribers.
That's right.
Pretty good, guys.
The first 100.
Right. That's right. We're trying to get that first
100. They say that the first 100 is the hardest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's right.
That's
true. I'm going to frame the first 100 up in my room.
No matter what,
I'm going to get all your usernames.
Yeah. No. No matter what the username is, number 100 gets framed.
I'm gonna put it all in my room.
Hello.
Hi. Sorry about that.
No, that's okay.
So yeah, we have the 11:20 on Tuesday. You wanted to book that one, yeah?
Okay, that sounds good. And real quick, I'm just really thankful for this whole thing. Again, it's been like kind of years of neglect on my skin, you know, new year, new me. And I kind of just wanted to sing you a little something to express my gratitude. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Thank you for fixing my skin. It was patchy and hard, but soon will be smooth. Please do not be disturbed by my boils and give me all of those good face oils. Thank you for fixing my skin.
Hello?
Maybe now I can shave my beard.
Hello?
Yes, hello.
Hi,
I'm
sir.
Thankful to
I would
you.
Like to collect some information
Thank
from
you.
You
so much for fixing my
name,
awful skin. My last name is Wynn, and I'm thankful that you will be taking
hey,
care
John,
of my skin.
I really love your singing voice, but is there any way that you can just spell your last name for me so that I can put you in my system and continue taking my clients?
W-I-N.
Thank you. W-I-N. So that's John Wynn.
John
What's
Wynn.
Your email address?
JohnWynn@hotmail.com.
What's your phone number?
281
330
8004. Mike Jones up on the low, Mike Jones up on the flow.
Right, Mike Jones. That's the funny
you
one.
You got it.
Alrighty, and John, what is your, we need a credit card in order or a debit card in order to book your appointment. May I please have your card number?
Happy New Year! Dude, you do the mic job.
Yeah, mic job.
That's hilarious.
Give me your credit card number.
Why are you man and woman? You are now streaming Red American Podcast called S&D. Gonna be making episodes, so go ahead and click the download.